This video is brought to you by Vessi. Ah, yes, a tier list. Been wanting to do this one for a while now. So for those who don't know, last January, I did a tier list for worst animated films of the past decade. And I thought to myself, hey, let's do one, but with Anthro characters. To which I immediately realized that is way too much. I asked that question on Twitter, I asked it on YouTube, and I then figured out if I did a tier list for characters alone, it would be like 300 options long. So I figured, hey, let's narrow it down. Let's do a tier list of my favorite to my least favorite Anthro movies. So here's the way it works. We've got this S, A, B, C, D, F, I guess we're skipping E. Then we have haven't watched, and then we got a category called does it count? Because I asked you guys, I asked for recommendations. What Anthro films should I put on this tier list? And I figured some of these options might not count. In case that was what was happening, I can just put that movie in the does it count category. By the way, the rules, what qualifies as an Anthro movie on this list is having one of the main characters stand up on their own two legs, as in like it's humanoid, not necessarily an animal. Cause like someone asked me, what about Lion King? And I was like, I don't know if that counts as Anthro. They're just talking animals. So I guess it doesn't count. I'm gonna get chewed out for this one. I just know it.
Ah, off with his head!
Oh, and speaking of Anthro, just so you know, I got a new design on my merch shop. It's appropriate for this video. I know it's got four ears because, you know, I'm basic like that. But yeah, new shirt design. Folks have been requesting this one for a while now, so enjoy. On that note, let's kick things off. Just so you know, I did a randomizer with my picks. And I realize that some of these picks, I'm gonna talk about them and I might be like, why did I put this on the list? And here's the secret reason why. I'm stupid. All right, let's go. The first one here is Over the Hedge. Wow, what a way to start. Goes right into the have not seen category. I need to watch it. I've been told it's good. Not great, but good. Next, we have James and the Giant Peach. I liked this film a lot when I was a kid. I watched it as an adult. I thought it wasn't as good. I like the character designs. I like the claymation, of course. Claymation, the stop motion animation. But as far as the story goes, I was like, not really feeling it when I saw it a few years ago. So James and the Giant Peach, we'll put that in the B tier. Next, we have Rennie the Fox. I'm gonna put you in the C tier. Actually, no, I'm just joking. You're going right into the D tier. You're not that good at all. You were much better than I expected, but still not that great. By the way, ladies and gentlemen, there will be quite a few videos on this list of things that I've already reviewed, so you might have an idea of how I feel about these Anthro movies. Next, we have Barnyard from Nickelodeon. I never watched the film. I watched a few of the episodes, and as a kid, or I guess a teenager, I thought the show was dumb. But then I started watching some of the episodes as an adult, and I was a lot more warmed up to it. I think the show has a pretty good sense of humor. I don't think it's pretty. I think it's a very ugly show, but not ugly, but it's just not really my jam. But I do like the memes that come out of it. The mail call from Pig cracks me up every single time. It's pretty good, but I'm gonna put it in the D tier. I just don't really care for Barnyard. I thought it would be F tier, but after watching a few episodes, I'm like, okay, it's not that bad, but it's still not that good. Oh, what am I talking about? I haven't seen the movie, so never mind. It goes into the haven't watched category. But for the show, I would put that in like the D tier. Next, we have the Angry Birds movie. I haven't seen the second one. I was told by multiple sources that it's either like some folks who are like, oh, it's really good, and other folks who are like, wow, it's not good at all. It's worse than the first one. I haven't seen the second one, but for the first film, I was surprised. I thought this would be just complete garbage, and it's not. It's got its problems. I think some of the humor is very crass and is meant for kids, but it was a lot better than what I thought it would be. I also like the character designs. I like the overall story. I like Red as a character. I would put it in the C tier. Then we have Surf's Up. So I admire this movie for being different. I like its approach. I like that it's a sports documentary, essentially. And in that regard, I thought that was pretty creative. I wasn't, like, in love with it, though. Cody, as a character, eh. Shia LaBeouf, you know, why not? It's got its moments. It's one of those films where I wouldn't recommend it, but I'm like, it's competent enough. Now, the second film with the wrestlers, that is straight up like F-tier garbage. It is so bad, especially with milking fish. Don't even know what that was about. Then we have Cats Don't Dance, which I would toss right into the S-tier. I loved it. I love the designs. I love the energy. I like the story. It's a pretty short film, actually, like considering all things. I was surprised at how short of a movie it was with its total runtime, but it's such a good movie. I think Darla Dimple is like one of the best villains in like, oh, I say recent, the movie's pretty old now. I guess it's relative to how old you are and whatnot, but yeah, it came out in the, it was the 90s, I believe. It came out around that time when computer animation was starting to blow up, so 2D animated films weren't doing as well. But that all being said, I think the film has aged really well. I watched it a few months ago. I loved it. I think Sawyer, she's like one of my favorite Anthro character designs ever. I think Sawyer's fantastic with her design, with her actual character. Overall, I recommend Cats Don't Dance. If you haven't seen it, check it out. Also, Max is a hilarious side villain. Then we have the Alvin and the Chipmunks movie. This was recommended to me. I haven't seen it. I don't want to see it. I don't want to see these awful CGI films. They look awful. I don't want to see them. But I would imagine they would go into the F tier. Okay, so this one's a bit different. The Brave Little Toaster. So this one was recommended on my list. I asked folks, hey, recommend these Anthro movies. And somebody said, hey, check out The Brave Little Toaster. I've seen it, but I was like, that's not an Anthro movie. Well, hold on a second. Maybe it is. I don't know. I'm still kind of not sure if this belongs on the list. It's technically anthropomorphic, but I don't think it's Anthro in the way that I have clarified the rules for Anthro to be for this list. Wow, that was a sentence. But I would put it in the does it count category. I mean, if I was to put it on this list, I would put it in the B tier. It's very dark, not very dark. It's a lot darker than most kid films. I mean, you got like these little machine characters getting their guts ripped out. You got a song about dying as these cars are being crushed. And I watched this as a kid. I love this film. It's like one of the first films I ever recall watching. And I loved it. I watched it not too long ago. I still love it. It's a good movie. It's got its issues, but it's pretty good. Then we have Who Framed Roger Rabbit? That's S tier, easy. That is absolutely S tier. It is probably one of the most important animated films ever made. I know that it can be argued that Who Framed Roger Rabbit was the first film to really start up the Disney Renaissance. It's one of those required viewings, as in like if you want to immerse yourself in the world of animation, you've got to watch Who Framed Roger Rabbit. It is top notch. One of the best animated films ever made. Then we have B-Movie. Should I put it in the B category on the B tier? Whatever. Not great. I put it in D. It's a very sarcastic and meta kind of film. It's like Jerry Seinfeld. It's like, of course he made this. Of course he's behind it. It just radiates Seinfeld energy. But I don't think his comedy from like the show Seinfeld transfers well over into the big screen with bees. But if you like dry humor, then maybe you might enjoy this film. I did not. So yeah, there you go. Then we have Fantastic Mr. Fox. This is another film I'd chalk up for being like a spectacle, where it's like visually it is worth watching just for what it pulled off. Oh God, what's the name of the director? It's that one guy who's like all about symmetry and like really interesting camera angles and framing. I will type it out here in the video. Yes, this director. He's got a very interesting style, doesn't he? He did the Grand Budapest. So as far as this film goes, I like it a lot. I like the characters. I like Mr. Fox and his addiction. I like the ensemble, the other characters, the rest of the cast. I think they're like Christofferson, I think is the name of the guy. Overall, an enjoyable experience. I would put it in the A tier. There are moments where I think the comedy gets a little bit too far out there and loses me, but visually it's like wonderful. I love it. Then we have Open Season. I haven't seen this, so sorry. I'll have to watch you. I don't really want to. It looks ugly. But hey, you know, there are plenty of ugly films out there that have good stories and good characters. Yeah. Is it Ashton Kutcher? He's the deer with the one antler? I recall that much. Okay, haven't seen it. Then we have Goofy Movie. You know what gets me about it is that, like, a Goofy Movie is very good. Like, I put that in the A tier. You've got a good film about a father and son relationship, about them drifting apart, about a dad who wants to be involved in his kid's life, a kid who's like going through the rebellious phase of being a teenager and wanting to be, just leave me alone, dad, just leave me alone. And what I like so much about that too is that when I watched an extremely goofy movie, I thought that would get repetitive with Max being in college, but I think it works out quite well, where you have these different phases in life. And as you get older, folks, I mean, you'll look back, because I'm 31. Dun, 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 saber sparks old. But when you look back, you start realizing, man, that was a phase of trying to push my parents out of my life. Now, that is not the rule of thumb for everyone, but I myself see that from a Goofy Movie and a Goofy Movie 2. And I was like, yeah, I was there, where I wanted my parents to leave me alone. I wanted to hang out with my friends. I wanted to be independent. And as I got older, I realized, wow, what an emotional punk I was. Just calm down past Saber Spark, you loser. Next, we have Treasure Planet. Easy, A tier. I don't put it in S tier because, this is gonna be an unpopular opinion. A lot of folks praise this film, being like, it is just tremendous, the best thing Disney ever made. And I'm like, you know, it's good, but I don't think it's that good. I love the visuals. I think it's very creative what they were trying to do with Treasure Island, but putting it in space. Captain Silver? Yeah, Captain Silver. And just the cast of characters, I thought they were a lot of fun. That robot character, though, is like one of the main reasons of why I don't put it in S tier. Talk about a stupid throwaway comic relief character who just got under my skin and was so annoying. I did not care for him. But as far as like the relationships go with like Jim and Captain Silver and seeing them, like, cause there's a scene where you've got like Jim having a flashback, seeing his father leave, the father's on the boat taking off and Jim's reaching out. And in that part of the song, Silver, who took off on a boat in the previous scene, comes back to say, Jim, get on the boat, let's go. And I'm like, that's really sweet. Like you have basically, and of course, for folks who've watched the movie, read the book, know that this is a movie that's kind of getting at like the father-son relationship between Captain Silver and Jim and how it's making up for where Jim did not really have a father figure in his life. I thought when it comes to that, Treasure Planet was very good, but there's some extra stuff on the side where I think it brings the film down. Again, the comic relief character being a main reason for that. So A tier, visually S tier, but story-wise and some bad characters puts it in the A tier. But Captain Amelia as an anthro character, mwah, chef's kiss, she's top S tier. Okay, I gotta calm down. Ooh, let me dab my head here. Then we have Shark Tale. I'm putting you down in D tier. I hated this film. Like, not to the point where it's maybe not like upper D tier. That's not like a tier zoo video now. But I will give it props for at least, like, I have to reserve F and D sometimes for like truly incompetent films, which are on this list, mind you. But just the overall tone of Shark Tale just pisses me off. I did not like it. I thought all the characters were obnoxious. I did not like the, I guess, trendy humor and pop icons being used in the film at the time. It's aged horribly. I just don't care for it. I think Shark Tale just is awful and was trying to ride the tailcoats of Shrek and failed. Next, we have An American Tale. So An American Tale, the first one, I actually put it down in the C tier. I think visually, it's wonderful. It's pretty. You got Don Bluth who worked on this. But funny enough, I'd say Five Will Goes West is better. I put that up in B tier. overall, they're fine. I think Tanya is a pretty great character. Oh, Miss Kitty, I think it's her name, from 5-0 Goes West. I keep saying the name of the movie over and over. I love her. She's great. I think she's voiced by Slappy the Squirrel from Animaniacs, but like, she's a wonderful character. I had a crush on her when I was growing up. Uh-oh, I shouldn't have said that. Speaking of cowboys, Rango is next. Rango is S tier for me. It is one of my favorite animated movies from this past decade. It is surprising. Like, it shocked me how good it was. Because when I first watched it, I thought, oh, this film looks stupid. It looks crass. It looks ugly. And then I watched it and I just was blown away at what this film was getting at. We've got like this actor-like character as Rango, the chameleon, who comes into a town, pretends to be someone that he's not, only to see him evolve throughout the movie and actually become what he was pretending to be. It's wonderful. If you have not seen Rango, please check it out. I don't want to spoil it. The visual style holds up. It was very different for the time being and still is. And it's aged wonderfully. And I love it. I highly recommend it. It is S tier for me. Then there is Boggy. And then there is Boggy, I'm going to butcher the subtitle. I only put down the name Boggy on the list here, not the subtitle, which is like the mighty cat of nature, I think. Womp womp. I have not seen Boggy yet. It's on my to-do list, and we will get to it soon enough. It's funny because folks said that this was Tezuka's furry movie. Though, fun fact, he made this movie in opposition to Japanese like genetic testing and the government back in the day. It's weird. We'll talk about it more in the future. Rock and roll. Yeah, rock and roll. I put you in the C tier. Story's got issues. Some of the characters are unlikable. I'd say it's more worthy of its spot for visually what it accomplished and being so unique, but it's got its problems enough to bring it down to the middle of the list, but the visuals enough to push it above being D and F. So I put you in the C tier. Worth watching. Just for being so weird and out there, but there are problems with this film. Ernest and Celestine. This is easy S tier. It is so beautiful. I'm actually bummed out how many folks have not seen this movie. It's French, and the French are like, I don't think the French studios get enough credit for what they churn out. Like French studios make some pretty wonderful stuff. Like The Triplets of Bavel, that's from a French studio. Wonderful. That is a film worth watching. If you've not seen that one, check it out. But Ernest and Celestine, I don't want to get too far into spoilers. Just know that I put it in S tier and I adore the soft visuals in the film. It's beautiful. Then we have Robin Hood from Disney. Yeah, I loved this film when I was a kid. I would march around at the beginning with the characters, with the doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. I'd march around the living room watching the film, pretending I'm part of it. And here's another fun fact. When I was a kid, I would hide behind the couch whenever this guy would show up on screen. He scared me so much when I was young. I was like, oh no, it's the executioner rhino axe guy. Hide. So Robin Hood, it's funny. You would think that I would be like, yeah, put that in S tier. I think the movie has some issues. There's a certain part of the film. It's like right after the archery tournament where I think the tone shifts a bit too dark. And it kind of throws me off. I mean, of course, like, it's interesting to see, like, Friar Tuck get arrested and he's announced to be executed and that there's a, like, a prison, like, break. That's cool. Like, that's neat stuff. And these characters have wonderful, like, I mean, you got, like, Ollie Johnston and Frank Thomas, two of the nine old men who just are some of the best animators of all time working on this film. And you see some wonderful personality in these characters. I mean, look at those faces. It's great. Albeit, there are some reused animated sequences that have been, like, I guess, rotoscoped. I mean, it's to me, it's not the visuals that lose me. Because I love Robin's design. I think Little John's great. Prince John is my favorite Disney villain ever. He's just delightfully hilarious and how he's whiny. You got Peter Ustinov, who voices him. Doing Prince John was perfect casting. And that alone is like one of the reasons why I love Robin Hood so much. But I do know it has its faults. So I would put it in the B tier. I mean, Maid Marian is like an anthro character. She's like one of the four mothers of furries and loving Anthro characters, like her and Lolo Bunny and I guess Crystal from Star Fox. But yeah, Maid Marian, she's great. And Robin Hood as well, like being one of the forefathers of Anthro crushes. But overall, I admit that this movie has some problems. I'll get around to it in the future because I want to do a full-on what the hell was Disney's Robin Hood down the road. We'll get to it. All right, I need to move things along. This is gonna get long. Okay, next we have Rock Dog. Haven't seen it. I need to. Then we have Joshua in the Promised Land. Let's be real here. Joshua in the Promised Land. That's S tier, easy. You know why. Then we have Rock-a-Doodle. I put you right down into the D tier. Actually, you know what? No, screw you, F tier. I hated this movie. The visuals are fine, like as far as being competently made. I don't like the designs of the characters really. I mean, like you even got this kid who's like, I'm all furry. But like just the overall story, I did not care. I did not like this film. It's one of the worst Don Bluth films ever made. The only one that I think is worse is A Troll in Central Park. That was like truly horrendous. I hated that movie. Then we have the Garfield movie, which I'll be real with you, probably doesn't even count. I've seen it, did not like it, but we'll put it in the does it count category, because I don't think it does. Then there's Sing. Oh boy, I don't want to get that one guy upset. For those who don't know, I got chewed out via email. This one guy is like, how dare you call Sing mediocre, you heathen? He actually called me much worse words than that. But Sing was mediocre. Yeah, I put you in the D tier. It was just like not really doing it for me. It was like enough to be like, you know, okay, this film's competent. It's got, I guess, writers who wrote the film and voice actors and animators who tried to make something that's at least, again, competent. But I find the overall affair quite boring and not really worth rewatching. So, it just seems normie to me. And that's not me being cruel to normies, because I don't like that word. But it just seems like it was made for mainstream audiences and for moms and their kids. Then we have The Rescuers Down Under, which is, to me, better than the first Rescuers. I would say I would put that in the B tier. Then we have Stuart Little. I've watched it. I can't remember it. So I should probably put in the haven't seen category, technically. It's been so long. So sorry, we'll double back on you in the future. Don't really have high hopes, though. Then we have Kung Fu Panda. So as far as divvying this one up, because it's a trilogy, I'd say, of course, the second film is S tier, the first film is A tier, and the third film is B tier. The second one's great. It's great. The villain's wonderful, and the story of Poe and the pandas and how they dive into that is fantastic. And of course, like, the visuals in Kung Fu Panda are wonderful. Like, even in the third film, it still looked great. And I love Poe as a character. I think Jack Black was wonderfully casted. That's how you say it. He was the perfect pick for Poe. He was wonderful. So overall, that's how I'd divvy up the three. And I should probably put the posters up there. Then we have Let's Go Ape. F tier. Then we have Zootopia. S tier. It's wonderful. It's one of my favorite Anthro movies, if not one of my favorite animated movies ever. Some of the best world building I've ever seen in a film. And then on the polar opposite of Zootopia, you've got Norm of the North. And I've seen all of them. They're all terrible. I want to blow up right now just thinking about them. It's insane how bad these films are. And like for some reason, Norm of the North and all of its sequels, like I don't know if this was on purpose, but they have a lot to do with China. So I don't know if Norm of the North is being like targeted towards Chinese audiences. I know that sounds weird. I'll talk about it in a future video, but Norm of the North goes right into the F tier across the board. Then we have Hoodwinked. Haven't seen it. I need to, though I also been told I don't need to. I'll check it out in the future. Then we have the SpongeBob movie, which I don't know if that counts. I really don't. If it does, I put it in the A tier. I think it's the best SpongeBob film of the two that exist, I guess technically. Though the third one is on its way, though it's been pushed back, but it's on its way. SpongeBob movie though, A tier. I thought it had a wonderful tone. I wish the show would have ended after that. Like, here's a SpongeBob movie and we're done. That would have been a great place to end it, but I guess not. Then we have Animal Olympics. I put you in the A tier as well, just visually and from a concept point of view. Very interesting and unique. Madagascar. I've only seen the first one. I need to see the other two. Madagascar one though is really funny. I enjoyed it. I put you in the A tier. Roadside Romeo, D tier. Take that, Charliana. Wolf Children. I've not seen it yet. I've been told it's fantastic, but I have not seen it. I need to check that one out. Ants. Ant-Man. I put you in the C tier. When I was a kid, I loved the termite battle. I saw it again. I still think it's really cool. Ants is much darker than Bug's Life. Like, Bug's Life is a lot more happy-go-lucky. I actually think Ants is better than Bug's... No, it's not. No, it's not. No, it's not. It's not. I just don't really care for either. I think they're both, like, eh, serviceable. I'd say that they're competent. They're both okay. So, for Ants, I put you in the C tier. And then for Bug's Life, which is on this list, I put it just a little bit above Ants. Then we have Chicken Run. So funny enough, it was just like announced like yesterday, since I've started recording this video on the day that I'm recording it, that there's going to be a Chicken Run 2 film on Netflix. So that's interesting. I was not expecting that. Chicken Run's good. I put it in B tier. I think it's solid and it's fun and it's cool seeing it in stop motion. And I guess it's claymation. I think, is it Aardman who did it? As I say out loud to myself, not knowing the answer. Oh, the Great Mouse Detective. So this is like one of the most unappreciated films from Disney. Basil of Baker Street. Ratigan is just fantastic. A great Disney villain. One of the best. He does not get enough credit. I would put The Great Mouse Detective in S tier. I love it. It's such a fun film and wonderful characters to follow, seeing essentially Sherlock Holmes, to essentially see the persona of Sherlock Holmes running around solving crimes in London. So who put the Cats movie on here? Which jerk said, put the Cats movie on this list, Saber Spark? It's F tier. Just shut up. Oh, and the Nuttiest Nutcracker. That's F tier too. You all suck. What's this list? What's going on right now? Ratatouille? I haven't seen it yet, but I swear it's probably F tier. Okay, whew, Bad Cat, thank God. Bad Cat I put in C tier. It's a lot better than I thought. It's got its problems, of course, but as far as like what I expected going into it, it was much better than what I thought it would be. Flushed Away, haven't seen it. I need to watch Flushed Away. It's like one of the forgotten DreamWorks films. Chicken Little, ew. Zach Braff, ew. I don't mean that. I don't know anything about Zach Braff. Look at this picture though of Chicken Little in his chair. It's like, wow, that just screams Matrix with like Morpheus in his chair. Ew. Oh, is Chicken Little taking the red pill or the blue pill? Uh-oh. Chicken Little, D tier. It's like one of the worst Disney films. I wouldn't say it's like garbage, like the absolute worst. I just don't really care for it. I remember when I was a kid, it was the only movie that my dentist office would play. So whenever I'd go, it's like, okay, here's Chicken Little again. I don't know if folks can relate to me on that one or not, but Chicken Little, D tier. Ooh, El Arca de Noah. D tier. It's weird, but not like good weird enough to save it. I just think that film's a trip. It's bizarre. It's worth watching just for Panthe. Space Jam. I put you in C tier. Again, another spectacle where it's like, how did this movie come to be? Who greenlit this? How was this amalgamation of bizarre, like Michael Jordan and Bugs Bunny? I can't believe they're making a sequel. That blows my mind. We'll double back on that one. I've got plans for Space Jam. It is like lightning in a bottle, and I don't know how it came to be. It's, I'll be real with though, when I watch it, I'm not bored. I'm interested. So C tier, I put you in the C tier. Here we go, guys, home stretch. Sheep and Wolves, D tier. Spark, A Space Tale, D tier. The Cat Returns, ooh, S tier. I love that film. The main cat character, he is like the definition of cool. He's so confident, he knows exactly what he's doing. And then we've got the last two, which couldn't be more opposite of one another. Arctic Dogs, When That Cold Brew Hits, it puts you right in the F tier, which is where it belongs. And then possibly one of my favorite Anthro films ever made, The Secret of Nim. It's so funny that I was ragging on Don Bluth for Rockadoodle. It's kind of crazy how far Don Bluth, like that, this, the scope of his creations and how big of a gap there can be, where it's like on one side you got like The Pebble and the Penguin, A Troll in Central Park, Rockadoodle, and then on this other side you've got like The Secret of Nim. And it's like, who, how, it blows my mind that you made all of these films as the director? Like, what happened? Why is there such a gap between the story quality? Secret of Nim, though, highly recommend it. It's fantastic. I'm hooked on the story the entire time. And it's so funny because it all takes place in like the front yard of essentially of a farmhouse. And you're just following Mrs. Brisby going around trying to find the rats of Nim, trying to get their help to help move her family's home before harvesting season. It's like a borderline fantasy story. I mean, yeah, there's magic in it, of course, but I'm hooked. I love it. Visually fantastic. And I recommend it. So if you've not seen The Secret of Nim, please go check it out. And that really is it, folks, for the list. I know that this is a bit unorthodox, very different, but I wanted to do this. I wanted to at least present to you all my overall thoughts of ranking these Anthro animated movies, films that I hope to double back on in the future. Hey guys, if I miss something, tell me in the comments. I want to know what you all think, why you believe that The Secret of Nim is F tier and Norma the North is God S tier above all else in the universe. Hallelujah. Once again, a shout out to this video sponsor, Vessi. So for the past few months, I've been trying to run every day and get in shape, walking to jogging to running. And I could tell that it was doing a number on my old shoes. Fortunately, Vessi reached out to me and I was like, yo, good timing. My first impressions of their shoes was, wow, these look really stylish and comfortable. A few days later, I got my pair of the men's Cityscape in the mail. And I mean this, I love them. I legitimately love them. Even if this wasn't a sponsorship, I would still be saying that. I spent a few days trying the shoes out, and I could feel a drastic difference in my running, and how the shoes impacted my feet and legs. I was getting a better workout. The shoes are breathable, they're lightweight, they have amazing grip, and get this, they're waterproof. A few days ago, I was zoning out while I was going for a run and accidentally ran across a puddle. And I was like, ah, dang it, my new shoes. But then I was like, oh, that's right, these things are weatherproof. And my feet were completely dry. Oh, and I like how stretchy they are. It's like a sock, but you don't have to wear socks with the shoes. They are that comfortable. And I'll be real with you, I think they look cooler without the socks. Oh, and no blisters either. Guys, I pride myself on only sponsoring products and services that I would use. And I absolutely use these shoes and love them. So go hit up VessiFootwear.com/SaberSpark to get your shoes today and get $40 off your order.